let's just start out with saying how polite Jeffrey was, respectful, had a very big heart, felt sorry for people, and the biggest smile.
Hey guys, it's Deepa again, and we are here to finish the case of Jeffrey Crawford, Ashley Baird, and Tonda Nelson. This is a three-part series on this channel, and this is number three. So if you have not went and watched the first two, please go do that. So to recap a little about the first two videos, Jeffrey, Ashley, and Tonda went missing the day that Jeffrey and Ashley's trailer burned down. Ashley and Tonda had been seen with a guy named Ian and a few others that were four-wheeling that day, but Jeff had not been seen at all. It had seemed that the police department was hiding a lot from the families. There were a lot of events that eyewitnesses were there for that the police just claimed didn't happen. About 6 weeks after they went missing, the girls were found, shot execution style, in a shallow grave. Jeffrey has never been found, but there is a warrant out for his arrest for the murder of these two girls. Now, this warrant also wasn't released until the day after there was a $10,000 reward for any information on Jeffrey Crawford. I would like to go in a little detail here about them having a warrant out for his arrest, but never actively looking for him ever. They have never contacted hardly any of his family. He had a brother in North Carolina. He had paternal family in New York. He has a son in Florida, an aunt in Georgia, another aunt in Wheeling, and has a close friend that's in South Carolina. And they never even did a search of his parents' house. Trooper Johns has been quoted saying that there's never going to be justice until they find Jeff. But how many events they claim never happened that directly have to do with Jeff or what could have happened to Jeff? And plus, there is also no evidence to prove that Jeff is alive. There has never been any bank activity, there's been no cell phone activity, and they're clearly not gonna put someone in the witness protection program that murders two innocent girls. If Jeff's body ever was found, you have blamed this person for 10 years, yet someone who actually truly did this has been running around free. And a lot of people in the community don't even truly believe that the whereabouts of Jeff would ever be disclosed if they did find them. So once the car was no use to this case anymore, the police never returned it. So Sheila decided to sue the police department to get this car back because honestly, she just wanted to know what they had done to it. So in 2014, she had brought them to court and won a case for this car's custody. But even with a signed order from a judge, the police department continued to give her a hard time on getting this car back. So once Sheila finally got this car into her custody, it was completely torn up inside. There were cuts all through the seats and there were evidence marks into the 100s. The police just claim that nothing was in the car. When Sheila did get the car in her possession, those evidence bags were completely gone. They had sat in that car for years. This whole time, it really seemed like the police was trying to separate Ruth and Connie from Sheila. It really seemed that if they could separate these families, they could never really piece these pieces together. Now we're going to get into some theories that I believe are proven completely wrong. I see a lot of people mention that it's possible it's the Chillicothe serial killer. The Chillicothe serial killer actively seeked women that were prostitutes on the streets. Ashley and Tonda were never on the streets prostituting. And also, that does not explain anything that happened to Jeff. And the other theory I believe that's completely proven wrong is the fact that Jeff murdered these girls and is on the run. They found his forearm in the woods. I know the police say that didn't happen, but there are multiple people that have spoken up saying, no, I was there when that happened, and those tattoos were Jeff. And if you just find his forearm, there's no way that he's just walking around without a forearm and didn't have to seek medical help for that. Why were his tattoo guns for sale? And especially not from him. If a man is on the run and has a trade such as tattooing that you can charge cash for, why would you not use that trade to make money while you're on the run? He would have contacted his mom. Like, his mom and him were so close. Why would she have not heard something over all these years if he was still alive? Let's go into some small theories. Jeff could have been cut into pieces and fed to pigs. It's very possible it could have happened. It would explain why only his forearm was found. There would not really be much DNA anybody else could recover if that is the case. So let's pray that was not his fate. He was again cut up and put in a barrel of concrete and taken to locks 11 and dumped in the river. It would explain why there was a chainsaw in the trailer, and it would explain why they had to burn the trailer down and why there was also blood and tissue found on the chainsaw. Also, people believe that he might have been put in a well around the area. We are now going to get into a little of the bigger theories. So one theory I was told actually has to do with Ian. They had had a little something before her and Jeff got together, and that maybe he just wasn't over it yet. Ashley and Jeff were having a hard time in their relationship, and that is why she and Tonda had ran off to hang out with Ian. Jeff had came and followed suit with Ray's witness statement. Ian killed Jeff. So Ian took the girls to a place that he knew they would be found, and then he took Jeff and did whatever with him. He burned the trailer down. At this time, Ian had taken pictures of the girls and gave them to police because he was an informant, and he explained what happened, and they just backlogged those pictures for when the girls were actually found to hold the integrity of what happened to the girls. They were never going to say anything about Jeff. Nobody saw Jeff that whole day before the fire. Why would he just pop out of nowhere and kill these two girls in front of tons of witnesses? And why would Ian take these girls somewhere completely different? If he was wanting them to be found, why would he just not call the police? And like, why do you have to cover up what happened to Jeff? You could easily claim that he was killing people, so you killed him, and that would not have been an issue. What police department is like, yeah, just leave him there for 6 weeks until someone finds him? And what police department would say, let's backlog photos until somebody finds them? Yeah, that theory doesn't make sense to me. The next theory has to do with David. It is thought that Tonda was the reason that he went to jail for having illegal guns being a felon. If she was the reason he had went to jail, it could have been something that had to do with revenge. And also, throughout their relationship, we really don't know what was said or done to her or him, and it could have way more to do with something personal on those lines also. To me, I don't think it really makes sense what Ashley and Jeff would have to do with it, but one of David's family members had came up to one of Tonda's family members and told them that Tonda got what she deserved because she was a rat. So that's scary. This is the big theory that I, for the most part, believe. I think it has the most truth. But this theory was told to one of the family members. Ashley and Jeff had a debt to whoever they were getting drugs from. It was about $8,000. So the big drug dealer around the area, somehow that money affected him. So he had sent James. He found Jeffrey at the trailer. Ian actually does have a part in this too, because he was used to distract the girls while this guy came to scare Jeff. While he was trying to scare him to give him the money, he shot him in the leg. When he shot him in the leg, it was not for him to be killed, but he accidentally bled out. They probably did, at this point, dismember him. And that's why Ian and the girls came back to the trailer. They had walked in and saw what happened. They then had to hold the girls and take them with them. And supposedly they took Jeff to a well and just dropped him in. Then they held the girls at James's home. There was a cabin behind James's house. The girls were held in there for about 2 weeks. At this point, this is when Fern had shown up to pick up his daughter, and supposedly that was Ashley and Tonda screaming. So the reason they burned down the trailer was to cover having to dismember Jeffrey in there, but there was blood and tissue on the chainsaw, so that could have been Jeff's. The girls were going to have to be killed because they saw what happened to Jeff. After they were killed, buried them in the place that we all now know. Of course, it makes sense because that place, and therefore he would have easily been able to do it fast and get out of there. Ian received the car, the four-wheeler, all the clothing, the tattoo guns throughout all this for payment. It doesn't really make sense what the plan was after they shot him. I realize it wasn't for him to die, but he was supposed to just go to the hospital and explain what. It is thought that if he had this big of a debt, he would have confided into his mother. It's not that she would have supported or even paid his debt for him, but she would have been able to help him figure this out and find him help if need be. At the end of the day, Ashley's family has suffered major losses since all this happened. Her dad has passed from actual broken heart syndrome. He just grieved so hard for his daughter and was never able to truly cope with what had happened. Ashley's brother was also killed in a motorcycle accident a few years after Ashley passed too. Ashley has become an aunt to 5 nieces and nephews since she's passed that she'll never be able to meet. Ashley's mom described it to me as like an emptiness that just would never go away. She explained, holidays are never the same. It always links back to wanting Ashley there. With Tonda's family, it's just so unfair. She was never able to be a mother to her boys. Tonda was not the absolute textbook mother, but she loved her children and she did the absolute best she could. She has even became a grandmother and she will never be able to bless that child with her love. And Connie deserved to be able to just be a grandmother, and she happily did it because she knew she needed to and these children needed her. And above everything, the family deserves answers. The boys deserve answers. Could you imagine not ever knowing what happened to your mom? And to this day, Sheila maintains Jeffrey's innocence in everything that happened. And she stands by the fact that she has not heard from him since the day before the fire. The public deserves to understand what happened to these people so we can help not let it happen again. And one thing I heard constantly is the fact that how much lack of interest there was from the community and clearly from the police department also. It was like nobody cared about this story because it had to do with drugs. They wouldn't even schedule searches. Their families weren't all drug addicts. Don't you think that a mother deserves to know what happened to her child? And because of this, it caused a very big breakdown in trust with the families who are completely innocent because it was as if nobody cared. This is all coming out around the 10-year anniversary of them going missing. And we can get the word going still. 10 years is a long time, but it's not too late. If anybody who knows anything can please just come forward and contact these families and let them know. And that is all I have for the Jeffrey, Ashley, and Tonda case. It was wild, but it was one that I really believe needed to be told because I hadn't seen anyone talking about it. Hardly ever. Just crazy with coincidences that can't just be coincidences. So thank you again so much for watching. Please like and subscribe for me. And also, hit that notification button. That way you're notified the next time I upload. Comment your theories below, and also comment any cold cases around West Virginia that you've heard of that you would like me to talk about. So thanks again for watching, guys. Bye.
I do want to know what happened. Absolutely.
Yeah.
I want to know what happened. The only thing that is important is finding him. That's all that matters. They can move on to what happened because they know where their girls are, but I can't move on to that.